I'm officially a fan. Hi there! Welcome to Reading Time with Duty. Today, I'm going to be reviewing Percy Jackson and the Olympians, Book 1, The Lightning Thief. So without further ado, let's get along with the video. The Percy Jackson series is based on Greek mythology. Percy Jackson and the Olympians is one of the many series written by Rick Riordan. So far, I have finished two series, Percy Jackson and the Olympians and The Heroes of Olympus. Now I'm reading The Trials of Apollo. I have chosen to skip Magnus Chase because I just want to know what happens after the Blood of Olympus. Just a quick warning, this video will have a lot of spoilers, so you're warned. If you want my spoiler-free review on this, here goes. It's a great book, I totally recommend it. So this book is about a 12-year-old boy named Percy Jackson who finds out that the Greek gods exist and they are still in the world. And they happen to live in America. And Mount Olympus is in the Empire State Building and a lot of that crazy stuff, but you have to read the book. And he finds out that he is a demigod, as in half god and half human. For a long time, Percy had thought his father was lost in sea, but he eventually finds out his father is literally the sea god. So here's the thing about demigods. You smell, and the smell attracts monsters. I don't mean to be rude, but literally you smell and you attract monsters if you're a demigod. And because of that, the attacks usually happen when you're about 12 to 13 years old. And because of monsters, Percy and his friend Grover, who until now he thought he was a human, but Grover turned out to be a half-goat, long story, but they find their way into Camp Half-Blood, a summer camp for demigods. Camp Half-Blood is a camp where demigods are trained to face the outside world. At Camp Half-Blood, Percy learns that he is the son of Poseidon, the Lord of the Sea, the father of horses, and the Earth Shaker, and is the son of the Big Three. By the way, hold up. Big Three means the three great Greek gods. First, Zeus, who's the Lord of the Sky and the Master of Lightning, blah, blah, blah. Then Poseidon, who's the Lord of the Sea, Father of Horses, and the Earth Shaker. And Lord Hades, who is the Lord of the Underworld and the Dead. So, if you happen to be a child of any of these three, you are very powerful, and it often means that monsters find you even more faster. After he gets claimed by his father, Percy realizes there's some problem in Olympus. Well, what basically happens is that Zeus lost his master lightning bolt. And you know how brothers and sisters are like, they bicker with each other. And so, naturally, Zeus blamed his brother Poseidon for stealing it. And a long story, Percy is granted a quest to find the master bolt and give it back to Zeus. So Percy goes on this killer quest to find Zeus's lightning bolt with Annabeth Chase, who's the daughter of Athena, yep, the Athena, goddess of wisdom, and Grover Underwood, who's a satyr. I told you, right? Half goat? Mm-hmm. And they have this prophecy to fulfill. It goes like this. You shall go west and face the god who has turned. You shall find what was stolen and see it safely returned. You shall be betrayed by the one who calls you friend, and you shall fail to save what matters most in the end. So basically, in the end, Percy, Annabeth, and Grover find Zeus's master bolt and see it safely returned, as said in the prophecy. In the middle, they face a lot of monsters and nearly get killed and all that fun stuff. I absolutely love the series. It's very funny. It has so much humor in it. And it's all about friendship and monsters and a lot of death and all that fun stuff. and it kind of reminds me of Harry Potter. The story is kind of like that, except it's different. It's about mythology. You might think you won't like it because you don't know anything about Greek mythology. It's okay, because I started off, I didn't know anything about Greek mythology. I didn't know who the gods were or anything. But you learn, and so you get some extra information, like you know all the gods. Like, by the end of Heroes of Olympus, the series Heroes of Olympus, I know all the gods, all the monsters. It's amazing. So do check this book out. I recommend it for ages 10 and above. The whole series it's amazing. Currently, I'm reading Trials of Apollo, The Hidden Oracle, and it is super exciting. And Percy Jackson does make appearances in the other series as well, after Percy Jackson and the Olympians. The Heroes of Olympus, he's one of the main protagonists in that series as well. And in Magnus Chase and Trials of Apollo, he and Annabeth do make some cameo appearances. I totally recommend this book, and you should all read it. I give it a 10 out of 10. It's totally worth reading. If you want me to do more reviews on the Percy Jackson series, Heroes of Olympus, Magnus Chase, and Trials of Apollo, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for notifications on new videos. I'll see you later. Bye! You might not like it because you don't know anything about it. And kind of reminds me of Harry Potter. Honestly, yeah.